Chris, can you put up the lighting fixture picture? I didn't get a good look at it because I was by the phone. Okay. That's good. Thanks.
up all the carbon from the port because they shared that space. But now they have their own set.
Our kids?
No, just a homeschool group. Yep, general group. Yep. I was talking to myself.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to Museum of Glass. Today we have a very special guest artist, Catherine Gray. Where is Catherine? There she is. Tall woman in the gray shirt. Some of you may actually recognize her from television. She was the judge on the Netflix show Blown Away. And there's a new season of it coming out, I think March 8th. So Ms. Gray has commissioned to make a lighting sculpture. Can we put up the lighting photo? And this is going to be at the college where she teaches at Cal State San Bernardino. And we're making the big, clear bubbles that are going to encase the lights. So we have a gigantic wooden mold sitting in that big bucket. We're going to make a big, gigantic bubble and blow it into the mold. So just to get you guys started, I'll give you just a very quick introduction to how glass blowing works. Everything that we do starts out in our glass furnaces. The glass furnaces are the machines where you see the doors closed. If you look up on the big screen, you see a diagram. That's what the furnaces look like inside. So in each one of those, there's a big ceramic pot. In that ceramic pot is 1,000 pounds of melted glass. We keep the melted glass at 2,100 degrees Fahrenheit. 2,100 degrees is as hot as the hottest volcano. So our furnaces is like having your own little private volcano. We want to get the glass out to make stuff. We take one of these steel pipes. You can see one of them over there. And we dip it into the melted glass like you dip it into a big jar of honey. We dip the pipe into the molten glass, turn it around. A little bit of glass sticks to the end of the pipe. The pipe itself is hollow, so when you blow, the ball of glass blows up like a balloon. So each time we dip it into our big furnace to get glass out, only a certain amount will stick. So when we make something really big like we're making today, we have to dip it in a bunch of times to get all the glass we need to make whatever we're making. The glass, while we're working, is going to look orange. The orange color you're seeing is the glow from the heat, not the color of the glass. So basically, the glass is so hot that it's glowing. When it cools off, it'll be as clear as the windows in your house or your eyeglasses. The glass itself is made out of three main ingredients: sand, soda ash, and lime. Sand is the bulk of it. Can we put up the ingredients? Sand is the bulk of it. Soda ash is sodium carbonate. It's a chemical which makes the sand easier to melt. And the lime is calcium carbonate, and that stabilizes the mixture chemically. We throw those three things into the furnace, cook them overnight at 2,300 degrees. They all melt together and make glass. Do you guys have any questions so far? Yes. Can you say that a little louder? Who figured it out? We don't know. It dates back to sort of 50, 75 BC in the Middle East, where the area where Syria and Lebanon is now, but we don't have any record of somebody I discovered glass. So the answer is we don't know. Yeah. Clear. So it's gonna be a big clear bubble, but a really big one.
Right.
glass blowing is a team sport. We always work with a team. These folks that you're seeing are all extremely talented glassblowers. The woman who's getting glass out of the furnace now, that's Sarah Gilbert. She's dipping into our big tank of melted glass, coated her bubble, and that's called taking a gather, G-A-T-H-E-R. She's going over to our pipe cooler. When we dip it into the furnace, it sometimes makes the steel pipes hot. So we go over to that trough, we spray water on it. That cools it down and makes it easier to hold. Right now, they're looking for bubbles, anything in the glass that they don't want. When it's thick and gooey like that, we can just grab it, pull it out, snip it off, and then just round the whole thing out again. Do you guys have any questions? Yes. Will you let us take photos? Yes. Take as many photos as you want. Post them on Facebook. Wait. Oh, I would be guessing. It's pretty heavy. Catherine, what would you say? Oh, maybe 25, 30 pounds. Of glass, and maybe another 10 for the pipe. But the thing is, when you have glass on the end of that pipe, it always feels a lot heavier than it would on the scale, because it's like picking up glass at the end of the pipe is like picking up a bowling ball with a fishing pole. So, 25 pounds of groceries might not be a big thing, but put it at the end of a pipe and it's really heavy. So now they're shaping up the glass bubble. The tool sitting on the bench is called the block. It's made out of wood. It's stored in a bucket of water. As long as the wood itself is wet, the tool doesn't burn, and we can shape the glass without leaving any marks. So now we're going to squeeze the glass with a tool called the jacks and make a little notch in the glass so we have a place where we can break it away from the metal pipe once we're done shaping. So the tool is called the jacks. We squeeze as one of the assistants turns the pipe. And then so one of the glass blowers is seated to the left, and she's blowing. So you keep that bubble inflated. So if you came in a little late, yeah. Do we mix our own glass? We buy a mixture called batch, B-A-T-C-H. It's kind of like a cake mix. It's got all the ingredients, all proportion, and we shovel it into the furnace and cook it overnight, and then it becomes glass. But it's a commercial mix specifically tailored to this hand blowing of the glass. The same for what? I don't understand. Yeah, there's only two ovens, and we have one base glass that we use for everything. The glass that we use is a little different than the glass that goes into a bottle. The glass that goes into a bottle is formulated to harden very quickly so that a machine can make 1,000 bottles in an hour. Our glass is formulated to harden slowly so we can shape it by hand. One glass art, Anybody have any questions? It's made of the same three ingredients, except the proportions are different. The amount of sand that they use is higher, and that makes the thing stiffer and harden quicker. But so the glass in your window is more similar to the glass in a bottle. Ours is soft and stays hot and soft a longer time. Our windows, it's kind of a tricky thing. It's called the float method. They have a giant vat full of molten tin. It's the metal tin. It's melted. And they pour the glass on top of the tin, and the glass floats kind of like oil and vinegar in a salad dressing. Is they pour the glass out of the furnace on one end. As it moves over the tin, it cools and hardens, and then on the other end it goes onto a conveyor belt. So they're continuously pouring the glass onto the tin. It's called the float method, and it started in the 1950s. So they just pour it out by the mile. And because it's poured onto this molten surface, the glass is, you know, perfectly smooth.
Yes.
How long? Me? Oh, since the beginning of time. I used to blow glass here with Fred Flintstone. There is no official hierarchy here in the United States. There are still, that kind of thing exists in Europe, but here, no.
What?
I mean, these guys you see working here are all super good professionals. Ben, he's been blowing glass for 30 years. Catherine, probably 30 years. Sarah Gilbert, 23 years. Gabe, 27 years. So these guys are full on, you know, you can call them masters, but there's no official designation here. So we're getting ready to take another gather. We're going to coat that bubble with more hot molten glass. This thing's going to get really heavy. Before we take the gather, we just hold the glass in the air and let it cool and stiffen a bit so that the bubble doesn't collapse under the fresh, hot molten glass.
Yes.
So to make it bigger and add more glass, do you have to melt the original bubble at the same time?
No, it's what you see right now. We just let the bubble stay out for a while till it stiffens up, and then we just dip it in the molten glass again, and we get another coating. There you go. So now we have a new, fresh, hot layer of molten glass. Going over to the pipe cooler. We spray water on that metal pipe to cool it down, make it easier to hold. We'll shape it in the block over to your right. We're bringing out our mold for blowing this big lighting fixture. It's a two-piece mold. It's carved on the inside to the shape that we want the glass. We keep it wet. It's made out of wood. We'll drop the bubble in there, close it around the bubble, and blow. Can we put up the mold blowing drawing? Can we put up the mold blowing drawing?